Self-advocacy, finding your voice. Self-advocacy is the act of speaking up for yourself in order to receive what you need or want. In order to be able to self-advocate successfully, it's important to know your own strengths, weaknesses, and needs. To be able to discuss your disability with others, you should also know your rights and responsibilities, as well as research and learn about topics that impact you. Do you ever ask a teacher to explain something you don't understand, or talk with adults about giving you more freedom and responsibility? If so, you're already on your way to becoming a stronger self-advocate. So why should you become a better self-advocate? Well, now that you are becoming an adult yourself, you should have a say in what you do, in what you want, and in where you are going. Being able to make your own decisions is important, because it allows you to live as independently as possible and do the things you like, as well as pursue goals after high school, get a job in the career field you want, and have healthy relationships. It also allows you to control your own body and health, manage your own money, and get the services and supports you need. There are 4 steps to becoming a self-advocate. You need to get to know yourself, learn your rights and responsibilities, then speak up and team up. Get to know yourself. What are your strengths? What are your weaknesses? What are your dreams and goals for the future? Understanding your rights. The Americans with Disabilities Act, ADA, protects the legal rights of people with disabilities. An individual with a disability is a person who has a physical or mental impairment that substantially limits one or more major life activities. The ADA prohibits discrimination from private employers, state and local employment agencies and labor unions, and public entities, requiring them to provide reasonable accommodations that allow full participation of people with disabilities. What are reasonable accommodations? Reasonable accommodations are adjustments or modifications provided by an organization or employer to enable people with disabilities to have equal access to services and employment opportunities. Accommodations vary depending upon the needs of each individual, as every disability in every person is unique. Some examples are: individuals with autism may request a quiet office space to reduce distractions, or individuals with low or no vision may request work materials in a different format, like large print, braille, or on the computer. They may also request screen reader software for the computer. Individuals with physical disabilities may request an accessible workspace, more flexible hours, and aids for writing or computing. What are some supports that you may need? To work, to live independently, to get places, to make new friends. Let's practice. Michael is a journalist who has autism and experiences sensitivity to visual and auditory distractions. He wrote for his school paper in college and typically completed his articles in the quietest room of the school library. His desk for his new job is in the front of the office in a high traffic area that is noisy. He cannot get his work done. What should Michael do? Jane is 25 years old and lives in her own apartment with a roommate. Her roommate is very messy and leaves things all over the place. Jane has a visual impairment and needs a clear path to move around the apartment without falling down. What should Jane do? What is an example of how you can self-advocate? It's your turn to speak.